Hi, my name is Dan Schwartz, an applications engineer at Keysight Technologies. In this video, a simple ADS design example will be presented, a design that works well in circuit simulation. But as with any real fabricated circuit, substrate layout coupling or parasitics may induce unwanted effects, such as oscillation. You will learn how to predict and ultimately eliminate layout-induced oscillation using electromagnetic analysis. Throughout the process, we will be utilizing EM engines integrated within the ADS EMPro design environment, Momentum for planar analysis, and EMPro FEM for analysis when magnetic absorber is present. After watching the video, you will be able to download the examples shown. Let's get started. Shown here is our starting circuit in ADS schematic. It comprises of about a half dozen surface mount components, an input amplifier with local bypassing caps, a single pole double throw switch, choosing one of two output paths, and output attenuators. For any real circuit model, such as a MMIC design that has sensitivity to power pin bypass components, it is important to correctly model the driving source impedance. In this case, we're using an RF choke, so the short circuit Thevenin equivalent of the voltage source does not short out the bypass capacitors. Each component has an electrical and physical model associated with it. Running a small signal as parameter analysis on the schematic yields reasonable results. Total path gain, amplifier isolation, S11 and S22 are all well behaved and vary with temperature as expected from component datasheet specification. Now let's look at the physical realization of the circuit as implemented on a single layer coplanar Rogers substrate. Running a planar momentum EM analysis on the layout shows performance one would expect. S14, the input trace with about half a dB insertion loss, and S45, amplifier output to input isolation of about 30 dB. Now let's go back to our original circuit, populate the components on the EM modeled substrate, and resimulate. Looking at the same small signal S parameters as before, we now see oscillatory behavior. Peaks in S21 at 12.1 and 15 GHz, positive reflection coefficient in S11, as well as stronger oscillations as gain increases with lower temperature. Remember the response peak occurring at just above 12 GHz when we look at the cavity resonant modes. Using the EM circuit excitation utility in ADS, we can easily visualize current through a physical circuit with fully populated components. This is very useful to determine exact coupling paths. Is there coupling to the power leads, output to input? Using this utility, all the effects are easily visualized. Also, this is why back in the original circuit, power into the active device was fed from a DC RF choke. Although this simplistic amplifier model has no circuitry associated with the power pin, many designs, such as MMIC devices, have highly sensitive power pins. If the entire circuit, including effects of bypassing on power pins, needs simulation, this is a method to do it. So, by performing an EM analysis in the physically realized circuit, we've uncovered a possible oscillatory condition before building the circuit and determined the oscillation is due to layout-induced output-to-input isolation of the high-gain amplifier. There may be circuit-level mitigations the designer may now use. Seeing how this is a video based on EM analysis, let's use the time-tested mitigation method of putting our circuit in a housing. We can build an electrical box into our momentum simulation to simulate a housing, but you will see in a few minutes why this won't solve the problem. We can easily import the already built substrate into EMPro. Once done, a housing structure can be built around our substrate. Before we run a FEM analysis on the housing and substrate, let's see what resonant modes the housing we've created supports. We've simplified the substrate to that of a simple copper block because in this case it is unnecessary to analyze the complexity of the substrate with all the ground vias. Running an eigenmode simulation yields the following cavity resonances. Several high-Q resonant modes exist within the frequency range that the circuit amplifier has gained. Most notable is a resonant mode at 12.3 GHz with a Q of almost 4,000, very near one of the momentum-predicted oscillation peaks of 12.1 GHz. We can also view E, H, or J fields for any of the predicted resonant frequencies. Now you can see why simply adding a box into our momentum analysis would not have solved our problem. In fact, adding a conductive box around the circuit may have made it worse, since we have a box resonance falling near one of the predicted oscillation frequencies. One common solution is to add magnetic absorber to the cover, as we've done here. Resimulating with a magnetic absorber yields much lower Q values. While the Q values are no longer in the thousands, the results deserve close scrutiny, since resonant modes still exist with values around 150. The designer may want to further reduce this by adding posts or changing magnetic absorber material. We'll leave it as is and perform our final FEM analysis using this absorber and our originally imported substrate. Running a FEM simulation on the substrate with housing and magnetic absorber yields results similar to the original momentum analysis. Except as seen, isolation of the amplifier output to input pins is improved to around 70 dB. Now that we have EMPro FEM simulation results, we'll save the results into an open access library that we can use in ADS to integrate our circuit and FEM analysis results. File, save project as, create a new open access library and copy your simulation data. We can add our saved EMPro library into ADS by going to Manage Libraries, Add Library, navigating to where you've saved the EMPro open access library, and selecting it. After doing this, you will see a cell in ADS that contains your EMPro data. After assigning technology layers to the newly created library and some manual modifications to the symbol view, we have an EMPro FEM representative lookalike to use in our original circuit. Running the same small signal S parameter simulation yields gain S11 and S22 similar to the original standalone circuit simulation. Most importantly, with no oscillatory behavior observed, we've successfully mitigated a potential problem before building the actual circuit. This procedure can be used for surface mount circuit, MMIC, or chip-in-wire module design, accurately predicting the performance of your circuit and saving costly errors and respin. Here is a recap of the method used to identify and eliminate layout-induced oscillation. A physically realized substrate was analyzed in momentum and integrated back into the circuit to uncover oscillations due to layout isolation. The substrate was then imported into EMPro, where a housing was built around the substrate. Eigenmode analysis of the housing predicted unacceptable resonant characteristics. Magnetic absorber was added to the housing to eliminate these cavity resonances. The EMPro FEM model of the substrate housing with magnetic absorber was brought back into ADS for circuit integration. Finally, simulation demonstrated that the observed oscillation has been mitigated and we can now build our circuit with confidence. To help you get a jump start to explore the topics in this video, the ADS workspace and EMPro projects used are available in the link below. Thanks for watching.